Hi, my name is Ron Means, and I'm building a website called ipundit.com, ipundit.com. And I guess this will be one of the first ones that, you know, we'll start with. The name of this video is going to be 3072, Truth to Power. Now, let me explain to you why that number is important to me. On August 13, 2008, my 98-year-old father was buried. That was the last day I wore a tie prior to January the 10th, 2017. And I decided that I didn't want to ever wear a tie again just because I really don't like wearing ties. So I went out and ordered some custom shirts made in China. That's where they make them. Sorry about that, America. With cuff collars and cuff links and banded collar. And no room for a tie to go underneath, and hidden buttons. It was really very nice shirts. I had 20 of them made, and they were made out of Egyptian cotton, which is a really fine material. And I had a monogram on, and it was really something nice. But anyway, long story short, yesterday, January 10th, 2017, one day after my wife's birthday, I put a tie on. Now, why did I put a tie on right on that day? Well, a friend of mine is a state representative, District 46 in Texas. And she was entering her 12th term, I believe. And she got reelected by over 70% of the vote. Her name is Donna Dukes. And I went and talked to her about not relinquishing her seat. So I want to tell you about this. But I'm going to start off telling you a story about people I know. I know a lot of poor people. I'm in the cab business. I've met a lot of people in my life. I've met governors, presidents, attorney generals, Treasury Department personnel, including the people in charge, people that have actually signed dollar bills. I know them, have known them. And I've known a lot of people, and I've known janitors, truck drivers, bus drivers, cab drivers, teachers, service people, regular people, maintenance people, plumbers, electricians, just all kinds of people. And I can make a friend out of anybody, I believe, if you're genuine. As long as I'm genuine and you're genuine, we'll get along just fine. But if you're fake, I can spot a fake a mile away. After about 10 minutes of talking to somebody, I can tell if they're real or if they're not real. Now, I guarantee you, I'm straight up. I come at you straight. I don't have time for games. I like to know who I'm talking to and what we're talking about. And I'll give you my honest opinion every time, even if it's not popular. Now, in my life, I've met a lot of poor people. And poor people usually fall for the okey-doke. Black people call it the okey-doke. I don't know what white people call it. They might call it the okey-doke too. I don't know. I'm not white. I'm black. Well, beige. But anyway, I like to joke about that. The fact of the matter is, the okey-doke is when someone tells you something and it's bullshit. Yeah, I said that word. And they sell it to you like it's real. And you believe it. And so they've put one over on you. And I just hate that. Now prosecutors, I used to be a cop, and prosecutors use this all the time. They'll get somebody in a bad position and they'll tell them, hey, if you don't take this plea bargain, you're gonna get 20 years. But we're gonna give you a probation. We're gonna let you off easy. So they can just write down in their book that they sold this deal. Maybe they get a raise on it. You know how people think cops get extra money when they write so many tickets? It's a fallacy. It's not true. But at any rate, they do get some kind of credit when they convict people or get people to buy their plea bargain, because that means they can go to the next case and they didn't waste a lot of time on a case that was easy. Well, sometimes people are actually innocent. And when you're dealing with someone who's actually innocent, and you sell them that okie doke thing, we gonna go on ahead and play this along for you, you're really doing a disservice, because there are a lot of innocent people that are put in this crossfire that really don't deserve to be there. I know people that have had to plea bargain because they didn't have enough money to hire another lawyer or to be able to go and get another different court or whatever. And they just went ahead and bought that and said, okay, I'll take the plea bargain. I'll take probation and I'll go ahead and do the right thing, even though I didn't do this, what you're saying. But and they might even get up in court and allocute to doing it just so that they can get that easy deal because they don't have enough money to stay out of jail. Nobody wants to go to jail with a brain. Nobody with a brain would want to go to jail. It's really harsh in jail. Take away from your family and your friends. A lot of lives ruined. And so I spoke to Miss Dukes, and I told her, I said, look, I've seen a lot of people. She knows I mix law enforcement. She knows me from back then, long time ago, over 30 years ago. She knows. And, you know, I told her, I said, I wouldn't, you know, she told me what happened. And I said, I'd fight this. There's no way I'd ruin my reputation and let them push me in a corner for something I didn't do. Now, if you did it, go ahead and take their deal if you did it. If you're guilty, you know, go ahead and take your lumps and take a deal. But if there's no real deal on the table, don't take that deal. And if you're not guilty, don't take that deal even with a deal on the table. I would never take a deal because I've seen too many lives ruined. And I just hate it. I have this website I wanted to create called Deliberate Injustice. And I talk about it on another tape. And you can look at Deliberate Injustice twice. You can look at it as Deliberate Injustice, which would be like what the jurors and grand jurors do. Or you could say it's a Deliberate Injustice, on purpose, injustice, where people get pushed in a corner and they have to go ahead and take a deal to stay out of jail because they don't have enough money to be able to afford to fight the deal. So in this case, in Ms. Duke's case, Ms. Dukes took a friend in, took someone, her sorority sister in, and gave her a place to stay while she went out and looked for a job. And it just happened that Ms. Dukes, after this young lady had shown her worth and showed that she could work in her house for her on the side, which didn't have anything to do with any state job, this young lady that was in there, this is the story I'm understanding to be true, that the young lady got hired for the state. She got hired for the state, and she was still doing these errands because she was living in her house, you know, sharing in the cooking duties and babysitting duties and all these other duties that people that would come to live with me, I would expect them to have to, you know, cut the grass and do whatever they have to do, whatever our agreement is. And so some kind of way, someone became wise that this young lady was working for her in her office as a state employee and also doing these private things, and decided to put this as an opportunity to jam her up and get her out of office with this flimsy nonsense. And so I've been told, not just by Ms. Dukes, that this young lady was put in a bind by a prosecutor or Texas Rangers, somebody. Told the young lady, you got to go along with us or we're going to file a felony theft of public funds because you did private stuff on company time, basically. And so the young lady is the one that's caught in the crossfire, and she decides, let's see, I'm poor, I don't have any money, I hardly have anywhere to stay, I don't want to go to jail, okay, I'll take a immunity plea and go ahead and testify. Well, what would you do? You'd do that too if you had no money, if you poor. That's what poor people do. They make stupid decisions. They don't fight. They're scared. They're afraid. They don't want to ruin their good name, especially when they're young. You got to think about the future. And I understand it. So at any rate, at the end of the day, that's what's going on, I believe, in this case. And so this young lady and some white guy, my friends, trying to hire some other ethnicity working in her office, because she represents more than just black people in her district. She represents everyone in the district. And so she has a guy over there, and he's supposed to go in East Austin and represent her when she can't go, and I guess he didn't like that. I've heard that from someone who should know. It wasn't Miss Dukes to tell me that. Someone else told me that. But at any rate, at the end of the day, she's getting jammed up, and I believe some forgery has been done on her behalf. Signatures she couldn't sign because she was in the hospital during the time and stuff like that. But at any rate, they tried to jam up Miss Dukes and take her seat from her, and then put some puppet, some person they can control, in the seat to vote and get push things through their way. I mean, she's been in office 22 years, 11 terms. You've been in office for 11 terms? Gee, it's time for you to retire. You can retire. Just retire. Just go ahead and say you'll retire and we won't prosecute you. And so she's thinking about doing that. And I said, have they offered you immunity from prosecutors? No. Well, why would you step down? Don't you realize they could still prosecute you after you step down? And you have no, what they call an ace card? You have no card in the hole, no extra, no nuclear weapon to blow them out the water once you leave office. Once you leave office, you're screwed. And you'll never be able to come back and get in office again. You can't run for dog catch because they have besmirched your reputation. And that would be a big mistake. So with that said, I wouldn't step down. I would not step down as long as I got the power. Truth to power. Now, you got the news media. Now, let's think about this. She's a Democrat. She's not a Republican. She's a Democrat. She hasn't done anything bad. Everything she's done has been to help the community. She's done fundraisers. She's gone over to Houston Tillerson. She didn't go to Houston Tillerson. She went to Texas A&M. Houston Tillerson is a predominantly black college. I went to Houston Tillerson. My mother and father met at Houston Tillerson. I met my wife at Houston Tillerson. And so that's the best thing I can say about Houston Tillerson, to be honest with you. I've done stuff for Houston Tillerson myself. I've gave Houston Tillerson their police cars. I outfitted their police cars, their whole police department. Helped them. Gave them a radio system. I did a lot of stuff. Didn't write it off either. I gave it to the school. I wanted to help my school. I gave them vending machines when I was in the vending machine business. Yeah, I've done lots of stuff. And they took the money, and I don't know what happened to that money. I don't know. I never asked. Don't care. You know, I just wanted to help my school. But at the end of the day, I never used my degree. I'm good. I'm good. I'm an entrepreneur. I'll find a way to make whatever. But she went over there and tried to help do fundraisers for Houston Tillerson, keep Houston Tillerson's doors open, because it's a private college. It's not publicly funded like Texas and Texas A&M and Prairie View and Texas Southern and Texas Tech and all these other schools that are publicly funded, getting money from the state. No, this is a private school, only on donations and students and stuff. That's it. And people like Lewis Hanna helping out the school and doing stuff. It's just, and my mother who was on the board, and Dr. King and other people, my father, whoever, me. But she's done stuff to help that school, and then not one person from that school has come to her defense. And that bothers me. This is about truth to power. Let's just think about that word, or that phrase, truth to power. You tell the truth to the power. And truth is power. It's supposed to be. Truth is supposed to be powerful, isn't it? Yes, it is. Well, let's just tell the truth. Why lie when the truth is better? And I say that on my private website. If you think about it, she's done nothing wrong. She hadn't stolen any money. This is the claim. You stole this money from the state because you hired this person that's working for you. But that person is working their residence. They don't pay me rent. They stand with me. This has nothing to do with the state. When they're on state time, they're on state time. And I just can't see how that could be the only reason that you all are after this young lady. You're after her because she's been in there 22 years and somebody else wants her position. Now let's talk about who possibly could be benefited. Because as a cop, when you look at trying to catch a thief, you got to figure out who benefits from it. You're not going to go out and steal some money and put it in somebody else's pocket. That's stupid. Ain't nobody stupid. So who would benefit if Donald Dukes were to have stepped down? Let's see. Who's running for her office? Got some Spanish guy running. He's probably not going to win. You got a couple libertarians, some guy who ran, and he got 30% of the vote because people voted for the Republican or him. I don't know how many votes he got. I haven't really looked at it, but I know she got over 70% of the vote. So Democrats in Travis County, Texas, Democrat. Mostly everybody here is a Democrat. There are very few Republicans. Okay, well, maybe there's one Republican masquerading as a Democrat, because I have a guy that ran for district attorney and lost. And he told me that the lady that beat him as a Democrat is really a Republican. So maybe we got one Republican in Travis County that's the district attorney now. She can't be no worse than the Democrat district attorney we had. She was out driving drunk and trying to bite cops and spitting on them and talking about how powerful she was, and she was going to get them fired and get them all arrested for arresting her for being drunk and driving crazy. So when you stop and think about it, maybe having a Republican in there ain't so bad, if she's a Republican. But does it really matter? I mean, if you're supposed to be a public servant, is there something on a public servant that says that you got to be a Democrat to serve, and that Republicans don't serve? Or is it supposed to be like this? I think it's supposed to be like this. So I know I'm digressing. I do that sometimes. I'm just sitting here thinking, who would benefit if she steps down? Well, Cheryl Cole would benefit. Cheryl Cole used to be a Place 6 city councilwoman, city of Austin. She ran for mayor and got soundly defeated along with Mike Martinez by Steve Adler. Steve Adler kind of reminds me of Donald Trump and Ted Kennedy. He's like a cross between them in looks, but he's nothing like either one of those guys. And I think he's fairly good mayor. I don't agree with some of the stuff he does. You know, I say we friends, we know each other. I don't think we're really friends. We're more like acquaintances. But I'm glad I voted for him, because when I look at Mike Martinez and when I look at Cheryl Cole, oh, I'm most definitely glad I voted for Steve Adler. Woo, 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 Steve Adler. I mean, it's the best of the three evils. Can't control him. Somebody's controlling them. I'd rather go with the guy that's uncontrollable. He's going to do what he wants to do. I like that. If I was the mayor, I would do like that. You couldn't control me. I would do what I want to do, just like I'm doing right now on this video, on these tapes I'm doing. I have nobody pulling my strings, and I don't want to be a politician. I really don't trust them, because there's always someone pulling their strings. Puppets. I'm not a puppet, and I don't like puppets. Donald Dukes is not a puppet. So I go with someone that's not a puppet every time. When you stop and think about it, somebody is going to benefit by them trying to push her out. And when they do a news media blitz, when they get on TV and they lie and they do all these things, it's supposedly to benefit someone else. Because it can't be about truth. Because if it was about truth, we'd already know what the truth is. Would no one have to go out and make up stuff? You know, no pressure someone into lying to stay free. Okay? And as soon as you succumb to that, you're going to regret it. It's going to always be a regretful thing when you're lying. Now, when you're telling the truth, if it was true, let's think about this. If it were truly true that Donna Dukes had stolen money from the state by hiring this young lady and got her doing personal errands, if Donna Dukes was not black, if she was white, wouldn't the state just come back and tell her you owe us X amount of dollars for the time that you used this person to work for you? Would they be trying to push her out of office? No, I don't believe they would. I don't believe it. So when you stop and think about all the other things that have happened in the past, because you know a foundation is what a house and a building is built upon. You got to go on precedent. What has happened in the past? When Tom Daschle, who was put up by Obama to be something, and they found out he owed X amount of dollars in back taxes. Did they arrest him? Did they kick him out of office for that? He may have got out of office, but it wasn't for that. He had to pay it back money. You know, are they saying she owes this money? No. They're trying to scare her out of her office. They're threatening with indictment and ruination over this. Like, really? Let's see. Travis County District Attorney, same one. Wasn't Miss Margaret Moore now. This was this drunk lady who was riding around trying to bite and spit on police when she got caught being drunk, and happened to be somebody I know. I know Rosemary Lindbergh. But that doesn't change the facts. When she was in power and she got caught being drunk, the governor wanted her to step down. But because of the rules, the way the rules are, he couldn't force her to step down. So what he did was he took the funds from the Public Integrity Unit and took them away from Travis County. And they had to disband. And so that's why they indicted him. They indicted Rick Perry because they wanted their money back. And he said, I can't trust you with the money because you got this person that's in charge that has obviously broke the law, and y'all didn't do nothing but slap on her wrist. She's still in power for 4 years. For 4 years, she stayed in power until she just didn't run again because she was embarrassed so bad. So she didn't run again, and then they got these new district attorney. And my friend who ran, his name is Gary Cobb, he thought he was a lock to win, and he should have won. But he owed his wife some money, or there was some money thing problem with him and his ex-wife, and she used it against him to help Margaret Moore get in. That's how she got in. It's all messed up. It's all messed up, okay? It's all messed up. And so when you start looking at it, you're like, well, why did this happen? Why did this happen? How did this happen? Why did this happen? There's always a reason. You start talking about truth to power. You know, Meryl Streep said something like this the other day at the Golden Globes. She started talking about truth to power. She started talking about bullies and people switching around the truth and doing this. But she turned around and did the same thing. When she started talking about Donald Trump, she never met Donald Trump. Neither have I. Never met him. But I can tell you this one thing about Donald Trump that I like. He speaks truth to power. And when he said what he said, and he meant it, he didn't come out with the these and the thous and the wherefores and all of that. He just came out and said it, just like regular people talk. And you may agree with what he said, you may not agree with what he said, but you got to respect how he said it, okay? And I believe that's why he won. I believe he won because of that. You know, you don't have to agree with it. And if Donald Trump had run as a Democrat, would you be down on him? If he'd have said, I'm a Democrat? But he couldn't have got by the Democratic National Committee because they were in the tank for Hillary. And that's obvious by the way that Bernie Sanders was treated. So they would have just screwed him like they screwed Bernie Sanders. And so he ran as a Republican. And he beat down all them guys. And then he won. I mean, wow, that's really something. That's something that's just astounding. It's astounding. And you don't have to ask me who I voted for. It ought to be obvious. Okay? It's astounding. You got to think about it. What difference does it make? Well, it might make a big difference. You get the wrong person in there, a puppet. You get a puppet in there who you can't trust, or you get somebody in there you can't control. Which one do you want? Now, that's the truth to the power I'm talking about. I'd rather have someone in that little position. They have over 150 state legislatures. I had to sit there and listen to them read down the list when I went yesterday wearing my tie. I had to sit there and listen to them read out the list. They call the roll from one all the way up to, I stopped counting. I was just listening for a couple names. A guy named Tomas Uresti, who's out of Bexar County, who I met outside, very nice guy. He took care of me. I'm visually impaired. He helped me, walked me up, made sure I had someone help me find my seat. And we had a really good conversation. I really liked the guy. I really liked it. Great guy. And then after I sat down, I met a guy named Terry Wilson, who was a former Army guy, officer, I believe he was an officer, up in Burnett County. Really nice guy, genuine guy. Yeah, he's white, both of them, one's Spanish, one's white. Okay, so I made the whole list. I had a black state representative, a Spanish state representative, and a white state representative. And I'm impressed by all of them. And so what? What's that mean? It don't mean anything. It just means I met three nice people. And when you stop and think about it, isn't that what we want? We want nice people that we can trust, that will do their job, represent us. That's why people are elected. They're not elected on popularity contests, which they kind of are. But don't you want someone that's going to do the right thing, or do you want someone who's going to be told to do the right thing? And that's the difference. So I'm going to wrap it up. I know this has been long. I don't know how long I've been talking, but I just think it's a travesty when you have someone trying to force someone out and you haven't laid all your cards out and you think they're supposed to fold their hand without playing it. Like, really? Who's gonna do that?